to the BERS YouTube channel following the meeting. Alex, can you please call the roll?
Sure. Peter Capagrella, Isaac Remignani.
Present.
Thank you. Julia Capone, April Chapman, Deborah Millian. Thank you. Natalie Green Giles, Michael Pratt.
Here.
Thank you. Vanessa Lim, Gary Lynn.
Here.
Thank you. John Matter.
Here.
Thank you. Donald Nesbitt.
Here.
Lindsay Oates.
Here.
Thank you. Corey Vester. Thank you. Shannon Wade.
Here.
Thank you.
We have a forum. Okay, the first order of business is calendar item number one. Noting the minutes of the meeting of the Board of Education requirements is compiled on April 17, 2018. The minutes have been previously provided to the board via the SharePoint site. I have a motion to consider the minutes from April 17, 2018. And a second, Michael, thank you. Please raise your hand and vote to approve the minutes. Please raise your hand if you do not approve the minutes. Any abstentions? Motion carries. Next on the agenda is the Executive Director's update.
I'm sorry.
You want to abstain? All right, so we'll get out of here. The Executive Director's update, Sandy, would you like to share any thoughts with us?
Yes, and they will be short. Want to thank Isaac, Chris Anthony, and John Mallory for attending the NC BERS University last week and the annual conference and exposition. I believe that all graduated with certificates. Oh, John. You did. Some coming meetings and educational opportunities to be considered. They're not all educational. June 7th, Local 372 is handing their scholarship fund dinner. We're sponsoring a table. Anyone interested in coming, please let us know. June 19th is the Common Investment Meeting for June. If you'd like to attend, please coordinate with Antonio or Evelise. Yep, yep. June 20th, National Association of Securities Professionals Summertime Fundraiser event for their Fast Track Interns. We take Fast Track Interns every summer. We support that pretty aggressively. We encourage you to attend. There are a number of trustees who are already in their interest. Please let me know if you'd like to attend. That's it. That's an evening event. And Antonio is getting an award, so we need to support Antonio. July 10th through 12th, there is a Korea Global Pension Summit. This is run by the people who help organize our conference. This is a good educational opportunity. It's generally smaller than NC BERS, and I encourage you to consider it. July 10th through 12th. If any of you want to come to me or go to Korea.com, K-O-R-I-D. July 31st, Trustee Educational Seminar and Investment Policy Statement being organized by Antonio and Evelise. We have a commitment of at least 6 trustees to attend that, but I encourage you to consider. That will be an important part of understanding our investment policy statement and recreating it with the graphic. That is July 31st. I believe it's 9 to 12.
Yeah.
Evelise, thank you. We posted today, and you received an email today from a day as a feeling on the pre-audit report from Mark's panel. A day's memo, email summarizing the content of the 28 pages that we put on SharePoint. We urge you to take a look at that. That audit is for the fiscal 2019 year, and that will begin in the next few months. And at the end of the meeting, if we actually get to that point, sorry, we're starting late, Mark Davis, our director of data analytics, will provide an update on the CDM benchmarking. You have a physical copy of the slides. If we don't get the presentation, we'll go through it in June. This is important to understand how it compares to other systems of our size, and we're hoping to have this conversation when we approve the budget, which is one of the things that's coming up very quickly. You know, you can get a preview by looking at the slide that Mark doesn't have time for that.
And that's it. Thank you. Thanks, Andy. The next items on the evening agenda, calendar items 2 through 17. The ordinary business of BERS, is there a motion to consider calendar items 2 through 17? Don, in a second. Michael, Alice, can you please tell us about the ordinary business of BERS?
Sure. These are all the retirements, refunds, and the deadlines that have been processed since the last meeting.
Thank you, Alex. We'll now vote on these items. Please raise your hands if you vote to approve calendar items 2 through 17. Any opposed? Any abstentions? Motion carries. Next up is calendar item number 18, adoption of the disability committee's recommendation. Is there a motion to consider this resolution? Shannon, in a second. Deb, thank you. Allison, can you please tell us about this resolution?
Sure. The disability committee of this board met on May 6th and reviewed 9 applications of these. Committee recommended that the board adopt the medical recommendations on 8 of these applications and also referred 1 application back to medical for their
So are there any questions, Alex? Okay, let's vote. All in favor, please raise your hand. Any opposed? Any abstentions? Motion carries. Next item is calendar item number 19. Authorization for the adoption of the administrative budget for fiscal year 2020. Have a motion to consider. Shannon, in a second. Don? At the April meeting, JD gave us a presentation on the budget. JD, can you briefly tell us? Very briefly.
This administrative budget for roads at total in 27 million, breaking down 16.6 for PS and CPS of the bigger budget than we have last year, supposedly, given by a move of the cost.
Thank you, Jay. Any questions then? Let's vote. All in favor? Please raise your hand. Any opposed? Any abstentions? Motion carries. Next item is calendar item 20. Authorization to enter into an agreement with Sports Recruits LLC for temporary office space. Can I have a motion to consider? Don, in a second. Gary? JD, can you please tell us about this resolution?
As everyone is aware, we have a budget that we have to make an application. We are in the summer, we will have positive state in this quantity, and we need to accommodate them. So we intend to do it for service in order to get some space. For this, we need to do it.
To accommodate space for auditors?
For auditors, it's just a need for an auditor. But when they come in, we cannot send them for a hotel, so we send some of the
You should see this as a temporary measure to relieve our current pressure on the 16th floor at 65 quarter, and then we get our lease at 55 quarter finalized, and by the way, that's going very well.
Thank you, JD. Are there any other questions for him? Okay, let's vote. All those in favor, please raise your hand. Any opposed? Any abstentions? Motion carries. Next item is calendar item 21. Authorization to enter into an agreement with Citrex Systems Incorporated to provide a virtual workspace. Can I have a motion to consider? Thank you, Michael, in a second. Lindsay? Steve Sibilia, our director of IT, is here to tell us about the resolution. Steve?
Well, the resolution is basically bringing some type of new technology for the rooms, and doing what just JD mentioned. We're going to have staff working outside to accommodate the staff to connect to our system. The Citrix provides a whole solution to the basically, what we have today with the application is not to meet the requirements. Whether you don't have much of the features that are being enabled, but Citrix basically is a virtual space where you can plug in to your work with high security, which is most important. Because today, with the VPN that we have for the department of that, there are sections that in terms of fissures developed. So with the citrus, you can basically, in medical example, check just check boxes. You can basically control the access and giving the workspace to the staff who got this work out. And just like today, it would be a lot of fun to do this facility.
Thank you, Steve. Any questions from the board for Steve?
Okay, let's vote. All those in favor, please raise your hand. Any opposed? Any abstentions? Motion carries. Next item is Town Line 22. Authorization to enter into an agreement with Century Link Communications LLC to provide internet security services to BERS. May I have a motion to consider? That and a second. Garrett, Steve, can you tell us about this?
Yes, we did have a Century Link as a platform for access to the internet. Obviously, there is no way we can use the secrets or get access anywhere to the work. So, CenturyLink provided the service to us, but still we have them in the building providing security for the internet. And the idea, especially that going to an open site, we want to have all sites, but basically if we move to 55 Oak Street, we're going to have circuits there, and we have the one currently at 65 Oak Street, and making a link between the two sites. One is going to be as we are for us, for this asset recovery, and the main site for the operation will be occupied at Water Street. And then the meantime, they will provide a security as well, because it would be very important for the communication. Currently, everything is basically we're hiding behind the department of communication in terms of accessing resources or what anyone can do to the system. So going out, we need the ISP to provide that kind of service for the staff of the operations.
Sure. We get down to the weeds because it's too much process. So if you like, it's going to be our ISP?
That's the case.
Are they currently?
We haven't currently assisted by us.
Okay. So we're approving CenturyLink to continue at 55 Water Street.
We already had a contract with them to provide circuit 65 Oak Street. They already provided one portion of the way. But still, this one that we are in contract with them for 3 days. And also, we're trying to get this package to provide for the new site, whatever it's going to be, to have also a circuit there for again access to the internet, obviously, for our ISP services.
So it's all sensor, ISP and is internet service providers. So the DOE hasn't been providing ISP for us at all, right?
Is that my because some of them are provided because we live inside DOE. We are inside that they are building. So we have those services available. As soon as you step out from that building,
correct,
you have that. So if we do go to 55 Water Street, we will need that service. Otherwise, we won't be able to get it.
This is also going to cover
ISP would be the maximum for services for all operations working to do the business, regardless of the business. That's basically that we are looking at all to do the ISP.
Any other questions for Steve?
Okay, thank you. Let's vote. All those in favor, please raise your hand. Any opposed? Any abstentions? Motion carries. Next item is Town Line 23. Authorization to enter into an agreement with Richard Nathan Consulting LLC to provide consulting services. Can I have a motion to consider? Thank you, Gary. A second. Don, thank you. Steve, can you tell us about this?
Our current consulting software, firmware, is being commissioned. And we're trying to do an RFP. didn't serve that we got home to our team on play so far. So actually, once we do this time, Kyle, who's our best player, scouts, go and find a different people that they go. For them to participate in the drawing. The city is kind of the complex housing system that is going to do for us, and in order for us to get the rights for people to come to the network, so we can get them into the housing
system. Do you, what software can you give to you?
Phone network. It's none of us for it.
Okay. So phone network provides what? Is that the
home?
That loops in with the VoIP system that we have.
It's a similar test. So now we're considering something test and also cloud. So we need someone who already knows when we look at the teacher to help us to the people.
Great, thank you, JP. Any other questions?
Okay, so I'm sorry, is this returning the web as well? Mm-hmm. Is this the same one that the consultant in Parks got that?
What? No, what is it? Because we took it and split it in half.
All right.
How long ago did this?
Well, it's also important because he remained on the team retained by Parks Panel to evaluate our systems. And we've got approval to use.
You've got a waiver, but you need one thing that's in the letter. Or both of them in the end, you said that the time itself is at the end. And you said that in those three months, after you would put it to work, and so there's no conflict on the work. You also contacted the conflict of work for to do the work, even though it's in conflict, yes, the same way. So then you sort of move forward with each other.
Well, what I'm going to have to do is confirm that the one in our manager, I read the audit report, which is not sure what, is handsome-faced and named around 36.
Oh, we don't want to get all at all. It's about it. It's and it's the staff job calculation he has, it's completely to find what he knows.
But if you're going to come to check,
so
we have
looked into matter of conferences and then informing all the conferences and tomorrow. So we can table this as a letter.
But also, I mean, if you want, I mean, in theory, if you're entering the contract, you still have to complete the contract. It turns out the contract preparation can't continue because the subject comes up.
Question has been investigated. We find to table this, share some information with you until you are comfortable. Because we can't enter into a contract until you are correct. So we want to be comfortable.
Okay, so we're going to table this, right? I need a motion. Not in a second. Michael? A second?
Sure.
To table this. So next up, calendar item.
So now we wait.
Get the vote on the table. All right, all those in favor of the table. Any opposed? Any abstentions? All right. Motion to table. Calendar item 23. Next is calendar item 24. Authorization to enter into an agreement for Davis LLC to provide project management services to BERS. Can I have a motion to consider? Don, a second. Gary, Daniel, can you tell us about this resolution?
Sure. So last month, we received a report from Chen Kermit, Tonio, on the state of BERS, and the lack of and the need for and under the BERS attorney. We want to hire the ladies to help us implement this project.
So what's going to be the deliverable at the end of the 7 months?
They were were selected for an RFP process that they want.
They have to put everything in the world, you know,
and if my own research could actually, perhaps you can help me out here. The two other folks, their bids were quite
They were ridiculous. We can't say how much, but it was ridiculous.
10 times more.
Any other questions? Thanks, Daniel. Let's vote. All those in favor, please raise your hands. Any opposed? Any extensions? Motion carries. Next item on this calendar, item 25, authorization to enter into an agreement with BCA Research Incorporated to provide informational services to BERS and look to consider. Gary, in a second. Lindsay, Daniel, can you tell us about this resolution?
Sure. So BCA Research provides analysis and data to BERS to be my 2015 for full instruction, as application, and how to do certification on our business.
Any questions for Dan? All right, let's vote. All those in favor, please raise your hand. Any opposed? Any extensions? Motion carries. The next items on the agenda are investment items that should be in executive session. I have a motion to enter executive session. Lindsay, in a second. Don, let's vote. All those in favor, please raise your hand. Any opposed? Any extensions? Motion carries. We are now in the executive session. Please turn the panel off. Alice, can you please report board's actions in executive session?
Certainly. During executive session, the board voted to approve the following items. Calendar item 26, authorization to control between the portion of the private equity portfolio. Calendar item 30, authorization to control between the portion of the real assets portfolio. And calendar item 31, authorization to controller to redeem funds for the board of the patient accounting system. The board also voted to table calendar item 29, authorization to controller to the portion of the private equity portfolio, and voted not to authorize calendar item 27, authorization of controller to the portion of the real assets portfolio, and calendar item 28, authorization of controller to the portion of the private equity portfolio.
Thank you, Alex. Next up, this is calendar item 32, adoption of the actuary determination for the final fiscal year 2019 employer contribution to the New York City Board of Education Retirement System. We have a motion to consider. Michael in a second. Gary. Sherry, can you tell us about this?
Sure thing. The final 2019 employer contribution was calculated to $270 million approximately. This does represent a decrease of $22 million from the preliminary amount, and this is attributed to the changes in the assumptions and metrics that this board has adopted earlier this year. This estimate was communicated earlier this year, and so it didn't contribute to all that. Having an information.
Are there any questions?
Great.
Let's vote. All those in favor? Any opposed? Any extensions? Motion carries. Final item on this evening's agenda is the fiscal note report from the Office of the Actuary. Can I have a motion to discuss? Donald, in a second. Lindsay. Sherry?
Thank you. So there's two fiscal notes that were issued that were released to the BERS since the last time that we met. One had to do with the cost of living adjustment. Currently, the cost of living adjustment is calculated on the first $18,000 of pension benefits. This bill would increase it to $21,000, so that would increase the vulnerability of beneficiaries and retirees. This amounted to an additional deferred contribution for BERS of $14.1 million per year. The second fiscal note had to do with those who retired that returned back to public service. Currently, if you earn more than $30,000, your pension benefit gets ceased for the remainder of that year until the following year. And this bill would propose that the limit is increased to $35,000 so that if you earn each $5,000 in public service, your pension gets this does not amount to a lot. It's $37,000 increase in core contributions for 5 and 9 years. That does include FERS, which is a very small portion of it, just because looking at the last 5 years of data, there's only been about one person per year earning wealth. So
of the lack of reimbursement cost.
Thank you, Sherry. So I don't think we have time to monitor.
No, but we'll organize either a sidebar or a June. Please, you can review the material though, CEM benchmarking shows how efficient we are versus other councils. And let me just add one thing, the engagement of our trustees is impressive. Thank you.
What we do. All right, that concludes the agenda for this meeting. The next regular meeting for the BERS Board of Trustees will be held on Wednesday, June 19th, at the High School for Fashion Industries, Manhattan. And a motion to adjourn. Michael and a second, Don. All those in favor? Any opposed? Any abstentions? Thank you. We are adjourned. Good evening. Get home safe.